Everyone, my name is Alistair Stewart. I'm a transformation partner at The Ready. We were really excited to get some great questions from our newsletter subscribers, and I'm going to answer one of those today. So the question was, what's the best way to get fellow senior leadership team members to prioritize when they get caught in a never-ending data collecting loop and refuse to decide a direction? Lack of data isn't the real issue. Such a good question. We see this a lot, especially with folks who are responsible for pretty high stakes decisions that can affect, you know, the future of a business or an organization. So the first thing I'd say is retro some recent major decisions as a team, or if there aren't any major decisions, just retro your decision-making generally, but make sure you talk about real world examples of decisions you've made. And for you in particular, question asker, get curious. You know, you say it's not a lack of data. So kind of what's going on there? How are they experiencing the process? What might be factoring into the pace of decision-making? And one thing in particular to explore is the connection between perceived risk and desire to do further analysis or get more information. So sometimes the sort of feeling of there's a lot of risk and uncertainty here and we don't want to mess it up can get conflated or confused with we need more information and analysis, because often that's how we're used to reducing risk. And so if you can help the team tease those things apart, you then have more options other than just ongoing analysis or more information in terms of how to reduce that risk and uncertainty. If coming out of that conversation, there isn't, still isn't a shared desire to, you know, increase the pace and quality of decision-making, one thing you can do is start to sort of measure or observe the cost, including opportunity costs, of delay in decision-making. So are you seeing the team missing opportunities? Are you seeing the team missing out on compounding returns where if you'd made a decision earlier, you'd start to accrue the benefit earlier? Are you missing out on real-world learnings? Are you just stuck arguing about hypotheticals when trying something in the real world would tell you, what direction things are going to unfold? One other thing you can do, regardless, that I think is really important is to share this foundational idea with the team, which is in most cases, you reach the point of diminishing return on upfront analysis really quickly, much more quickly than we think we do, because the world is complex and uncertain. We might wish it was mechanistic and predictable so we could analyze and predict the results of our actions up front. That would make us feel a lot more comfortable, but we just can't. That's just not the nature of reality. And so the best and fastest way to learn often, especially after an initial a little bit of information gathering and analysis, is to take action in the real world and pay attention to what happens. And so an implication of that idea is that when a decision is particularly risky or complex, especially when there's a lot of uncertainty, you don't want to stand still and analyze, even though that might feel more comfortable, because you're stuck in place. Instead, you want to take smaller, less risky actions that you believe will help you learn your way into those bigger moves while you reduce risk and uncertainty. So based on that idea, what you can do with your team is propose certain decision-making methods and authority based on level of risk, level of uncertainty, and cost of delay, and to propose and agree on those ahead of time as a team before there's a specific weighty or intimidating decision in front of the team so that you have those agreements in place. So for example, if risk, uncertainty, and cost of delay are low, then agree that any member of the team can and should make that decision unilaterally and without delay. Or when risk, uncertainty, and cost of delay are moderate or high, the team might make that decision using consent based on what's safe to try. So that you're taking action more quickly, you're learning in the real world, but you're still not doing anything that any member of the team feels is unsafe to try or cause harm or damage to the organization. So a lot of that was about decision making. So how does all that connect to prioritization in particular? Well, prioritizing is just making a decision to elevate one thing over another in terms of where you're allocating your time, energy, attention. And so prioritization decisions often are, or at least feel, risky and uncertain. And the cost of delay is significant because if you don't make a decision about what to prioritize, everything gets prioritized, nothing gets prioritized, and you end up standing still and not really making progress in the direction you want to make it. So if you use the above, the things that we've talked through to help your team make prioritization decisions more quickly while reducing risk and accelerating learning and impact by using consent and real-time steering, that's likely to help with the prioritization piece and with decision-making more generally. So hope that's helpful. Give it a try. Let us know what you notice or learn. We're always happy to hear about what folks are seeing in the real world. And we will see you next time.